Hello, everyone. I'm very glad to attend this meeting. I think we can practice my English. Yes. My name is Sun Tiening. I'm from China, and my school is Suzhou University. Today, I will introduce my new work, Rumor Detection on Social Media with Graph, Adversarial Contrastive Learning. Yes. I will present my work in four subsections. Let's start with the introduction first. As we all know, rumors are often harmful. They may mislead the public and affect the personal life and the normal social stability, and even directly have a powerful impact on the financial markets and national politics. In addition, due to the convenient features of today's social media, rumors spread repeatedly on the internet like awareness, creating greater potential harm. To effectively detect rumors, deep learning techniques are fully utilized. Previous work has generally focused on the mining the semantic information of rumor texts and wishes, as well as exploiting user stance and user credibility. In recent years, more and more study has gone to explore the importance of rumor propagation structure. Most rumors with salient features can be quickly locked by graph models. These graph models dominated by cross-entrop loss. However, these conventional models may lead to poor generalization and lack robustness in the face of noise and adversarial rumors, or even the conversational structures that is deliberately perturbed. For example, adding and deleting some comments. To address this problem, we propose a new method based on contrastive learning. Our GACL model is as follows. Given an input, we split it into two clusters referring to rumors and no rumors. Then the various types of data augmentation are applied to generate the perturbed rumor trace. Rumor trace, yes. Next, the representation of the rumor trace is calculated using graph encoders like GCN to obtain the future vectors. Finally, the futures and adversarial futures generated by the AFT module are concatenate together for subsequent contrastive training and classification. To better understand our model, we will introduce each component of the model in turn. First, the graph data augmentation is our first step. In order to simulate the noise in the rumor chain, we extract some samples with a certain probability and then perform operations on them, including dropping edges, adding edge, or misplacing edge with different probabilities. Meanwhile, in order to introduce noise to the text, we adopt the simple mask operation like this. Now we have Now we have some augmented samples. Then we mix the augmented samples with normal samples and use BERT and GCN to encode their text and structure features. Besides noise, there are more complex cases of camouflage in the real world. Rumor producer may use a variety of graph camouflage to make the conversational thread closer to the no rumor instance. For example, they may utilize the rumor bots to post lots of comments that quote many high frequency and indicative words to cover up the facts. But the ultimate goal of these cases is to make the rumor feature vector closer to the no rumor feature vectors in the late space. The AFT module attempts to simulate the behaviors in high dimensional space. We use the gradient ascent to perturb the future representation, which can generate adversarial vectors for press rising model to minor event in variety futures in the training phase. Now we have normal samples, noise samples, and adversarial samples. We try to put the positive samples belonging to the same class together and push away negative samples that don't belong to the same class. By using constant similarity rate, so that the model can clear perceive the different and differences and commonalities between different samples. Finally, we take the cost entrap loss and the contrastive loss together as the optimization objective to complete the training. Now let's see our in experiments. We evaluate the GACL model on three public real world datasets: Twitter 15, Twitter 13, and Fame, all of which are concrete from Twitter, that is the most popular social media site in the US. Both Twitter 15 and Twitter 16 contain four tags: no rumor, false rumor, true rumor, and verified rumor, which are used for quaternary classification. We have some baseline. You can see the SVM based on the low level had crafted features get the worst result. CNN and RVN based on the deep learning moderate text readout. Because CNN only consider local spatial feature, while RVN can encode global future information by analyzing top-down and bottom-up propagation relationships in rumor truth trees, so RVN has better performance. And GCN, UDGCN, and BIGCN are all GCN-based models. They all show excellent performance. GCN uses ducal attention to measure the relationship between rumor propagation structure, and context information, and more. UDGCN and BIGCN mainly rely on powerful GCN encoder to capture the global structure features of rumor chains. Compared with UDGCN model, the average ACC of BIGCN on the datasets is improved by 3%. By fusing the bottom up and the top down structure information of rumors. Finally, our GACL model beats all benchmarkers. The reason is that first, we use powerful encoders such as GCN and BERT. Second, we use some flexible graph data augmentations. First of all, we utilize a gradient ascent trajectory to construct adversarial explains to simulate hidden complex cases. Finally, we use contrastive learning to capture the commonalities and the difference between samples. The FAM is another disease. The FAM contains only two types of tags, rumor and no rumor, which is used for the binary classification of rumors and no rumors. The prediction results in FAM are inferior to Twitter 15 and Twitter 16. It is because that the content information of the post in the film is only based on the 9 events, and there is a lot of overlap in language description. At the same time, the average number of comments per source in film is only 30. In addition, we study the impact of the edge perturbation and the dropout mask with different rates. When the rate of the edge perturbation or the mask is set too large, the model will get performance due to the lack of information. Note that the edge perturbation does not change the semantic information of source and comments, and corrected rate setting will help the model achieve better performance. Mask operation will directly cause the lack of text information, so as the mask rate increases the prediction performance become lower and lower. In our work, the best mask rate setting is from 5% to 15%. Early rumor detection aims to detect rumor before they spread widely and causing a serious social impact. In our work, 8 different moments are set to verify whether the model can correctly identify rumors based on the limited information carried at the current early moment. It can be observed that at time zero, when the input date only contains source, the performance of the models is usually worse. But then the performance improved rapidly. This is due to insufficient training caused by a lack of data and also a lack of comment information that has been proven to be a key clue to classify rumors. Our GSL model is superior and stable at all different moments and successfully beat other benchmarks, which can prove that the combination of adversarial contrastive learning and a graph model can achieve robust and effective detection. Now let's see our conclusion. We proposed a GACL model that not only considers the propagation structure information of rumor, but also simulate noise and adversarial case and capture the event invariety features by utilizing contrastive learning. And under the GACL Fieldcom, we developed the AFT module to generate adversarial features that are used as hard negative symbols in contrastive learning to learn more robust representations. Finally, we experimentally demonstrate that our model outperforms state of art based on the real world data sets. Thank you.